22 students from Monroe County are getting ready for a life-changing experience this summer. They have been accepted by the Experiment in International Living to participate in their international cross-cultural programs this summer. We're going to talk all about this amazing opportunity this morning. We'll also hear from one of the students who will be going abroad. Heather, it is such a pleasure to have you here at the Southernmost House today. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. So the Experiment in International Living is the oldest summer abroad program in the country. We were founded in 1932. And this summer we'll be sending over 650 students abroad from 37 US states and 10 countries to over 25 countries in the worldwide. We're very excited about the number of participants we have from Monroe County this summer. We have more students from any other county in the United States outside of New York City metro area here in Monroe County, and we greatly expanded our outreach here this past year. So we're very proud of that and look forward to having the students on our programs.
What an amazing opportunity, Heather. I wish that I had something like this when I was in high school. Talk with us about what the students will be doing this summer.
So we have students traveling all over the world. All of our programs are centered around a theme. So we have programs that are centered around the sustainability and environment theme. So for example, we have Eric Whiteside from Key West High School, and he'll be participating in our Ecuador, Galapagos Islands, and Andes program. And in that program, they'll learn about the biodiversity in Ecuador and different animals and ecosystems there. We also have students participating in our France painting and photography program in Paris and Provence, where they'll be studying with a French photojournalist and artist in southern France. We have students who will be studying in Costa Rica around the sustainability and environment theme as well. They'll be learning about the biodiversity and ecosystems in Costa Rica. We also have students traveling to China, learning about the different ethnic minorities in China. All of our students will be living with host families this summer, so they'll be fully integrated into a local community and learning about the daily life of a host family in another country.
So, wow. Again, what an amazing opportunity. Tell us real quickly about the funding for this experience.
Sure. So our funding comes from a variety of sources. This past summer, we awarded over $2.1 million in financial aid and scholarships to 76% of our participants. So most participants receive some form of financial aid or scholarships. Mm-hmm. Here in Monroe County, we were very fortunate to offer a Global Leaders Essay Contest, which was a merit-based scholarship opportunity, which seven students were able to take advantage of. We also offered some need-based financial aid for those students as well. And in addition to that, here in Monroe County, we work closely with the Monroe County Educational Foundation, who nominate about 15 students every year to participate through Take Stock in Children, which is a mentoring organization here in Monroe County.
Mm-hmm. Take Stock in Children is a wonderful organization here in Monroe County. Well, Heather, thank you so much for telling us about the Experiment in International Living. We're actually going to talk with one of the students right now, Eric Whiteside. All right, Eric, I am so envious of you. I wish I could be studying internationally this summer, and I wish I had this type of an opportunity in high school. Tell us where you're going to be going.
I'm going to Ecuador and the Galapagos Islands, and I kind of chose that place because of like the rich ecology it has there, and like how the range of biodiversity of animals.
Now, Heather was saying that you wrote an essay and you were one of the winners and won this great scholarship. Tell us about your essay, Eric.
Yeah, I had to write why I was going and what I expected to learn from this experience. And I basically, you know, just made it sound good. And
and that's what got you the scholarship. Eric, why do you want to do this opportunity this summer?
Well, my whole family is about nature and, you know, conservation of the environment, and either Ecuador or Costa Rica, they're both like plentiful of you know, birds, butterflies, plants, insects, anything like you could think of nature wise and my like interest is in nature and like the conservation of like even marine animals.
Well, you are definitely going to the right place. You might have to come back on in a couple months after your experience and tell us how it was.
Oh, definitely.
That would be great to hear about it. Now, Eric, you are just a junior, so soon you're going to be having to make that decision as to where you want to go to school. Have you given that any thought?
I'm looking at Boulder University and up in Colorado. Uh-huh. You know, UF and Gainesville. It's just a little, that's a little basic. A lot of people from Key West High School end up going to University of Florida. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to try to steer away towards that because I don't want to follow the crowd and I want to follow my own pursuit.
Wonderful.
But yeah, those two colleges.
Good for you. Those are two good choices. Eric, I hope you have an amazing experience this summer. And again, I hope you can come back, talk with us, share some videos and some photos of your travels.
Definitely. I will.